So with these drugs as one part of the armamentarium came the Urni. And it is interesting to see that Urni made a lot of difference as far as treatment modality of heart failure is concerned. Can replacing an ACE inhibitor with Urni is likely to help reduce the symptoms and help him achieve better quality of life or not. The NT-proBNP concentration reduced significantly during the first 2 weeks of therapy of Urni. As you know, heart failure is becoming more and more of a problem, not only as far as symptomatology is concerned, but the mortality associated with heart failure. And it is very, very reassuring that people are recognizing the problems related to heart failure. And we see more and more OPDs and other things coming up in the hospitals as far as management of heart failure is concerned. I am going to talk about heart failure, the management of heart failure, with an emphasis on Urni. We are all aware that over the years we have seen that there has been a significant benefit as far as treatment modalities which are there for heart failure. We started with the beta blockers and the ACE inhibitors, then we had the ARBs and the MRAs. And we find that with beta blockers and MRA, there has been almost about 30 to 35% reduction in the mortality. And with ACE inhibitors and ARB, that has been a reduction of almost about 17 to 18%. However, it is significant to note that the mortality remains quite high within 5 years of diagnosis, and almost 50% of the patients die in spite of this therapy within 5 years. So with these drugs as one part of the armamentarium came the Urni. And it is interesting to see that Urni made a lot of difference as far as treatment modality of heart failure is concerned. Just to recapitulate, what is Urni? This is a combination of two drugs, sacubitril and valsartan. And sacubitril is the prodrug which gets converted to LBQ657, which is the neprisilin inhibitor. As you know, neprisilin is the enzyme which disintegrates the natropeptides in the body, and these are the ones which are likely to be helpful in heart failure, because if you suppress the neprisilin, the levels of these natropeptides is going to be increased, enhancing vasorelaxation, giving rise to decrease in the blood pressure, decrease in the sympathetic tone, decrease in the aldosterone levels, decrease in the fibrosis which may come subsequently, decrease the hypertrophy, and increase the natriuresis, which will be beneficial as far as treatment of heart failure is concerned. As far as valsartan is concerned, it is going to block the AT receptor 81 receptor, and by inhibiting that, it is going to decrease the vasoconstriction and going to have the same beneficial effects which you find with the natriuretic peptides. Now you must remember that the drug Urni is not two drugs together, it's a molecule which is together, and that is important to note. The advantage or the benefits of this particular drug Urni was very widely demonstrated in the first trial, that was the PARADIGM trial, heart failure trial, and wherein they used this drug and compared with enalapril 10 milligram twice a day. The dosage which was used was anywhere from 100 milligrams twice a day to about 200 milligrams. And they showed the largest mortality or morbidity benefits in patients who have heart failure with reduced ejection fractions. And this study was very, very unique in that it has most geographically diverse patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction. Also, they were racially diverse as far as the heart failure trial was concerned. We all know that the primary outcome with PARADIGM heart failure trial was that there was almost about 20% reduction in cardiovascular death or heart failure hospitalization. There was 20% reduction in cardiovascular mortality and almost about 20% reduction in heart failure hospitalization. The secondary outcome was also important, that there was almost about 16% reduction in all-cause mortality with ERNI as against enalapril. So ERNI was superior to enalapril in reducing symptoms as well as mortality benefits, as well as heart failure hospitalization was concerned. Next in trial came the transition trial and the pioneer heart failure trial. The transition trial was important in the sense it shows the importance of starting ERNI very early in patients who have acute decompensated heart failure. And what was that? It showed that you can use ERNI as early as you have treated the patients out of the acute decompensated heart failure, and you can start using them, putting them on ERNI right from the hospitalizing day, or you can use it immediately after discharge. That means within 10 weeks you can start this treatment. And they found that initiation of the ERNI in a wide range of heart failure with reduced ejection fraction early after acute decompensated heart failure event in the hospital or shortly after discharge is feasible, and it is very well well tolerated. Next came the pioneer heart failure, and it showed that there is almost about 30% reduction in the NT-proBNP with ERNI amongst hemodynamically stabilized acute heart failure patients with reduced ejection fraction as compared to enalapril. There was almost about 46% reduction in the serious composite event, that is risk of death, heart failure rehospitalization, and use of other LVSS device. There was also 44% reduction in heart failure rehospitalization. So it was very, very significant as far as these two trials are concerned. Then came the thing as to how this ERNI is affecting such a good prognosis in this patient. So we want to see what is the impact of ERNI on LV remodeling and the LV ejection fraction. And it was seen that when you start these patients on ERNI, there is increase in the LV ejection fraction over the treatment period. And the increase in the LV ejection fraction at the end of 9 months is almost about 5 to 10%, which is quite significant as far as heart failure is concerned. What happens to the cardiac remodeling? Now, when you have a patient who has gone into left ventricular failure, you tend to get what is called as remodeling. The heart remodels. And if you avoid this remodeling, then there is likely to be an improvement in the LV function. With ERNI, you find that the LVEF, as I already said, improves and increases. But also, there is a decrease in the LV end diastolic diameter. Also, there is a reduction in the LV end diastolic volume, and there is also a reduction in the LV end diastolic volume index. So after 9 months of ERNI, they found that there is significant improvement in the NYHA class. There was reduction in the LV diastolic diameter, LV end diastolic volume, as well as the LV end diastolic volume index. And the EF increased almost to the tune of about 10%. Now, what is this reverse remodeling which occurs, which helps for improving in the LV ejection fraction? And it was found that higher the doses of sacubitril and valsartan combination which were used, which significantly associated with higher degrees of left ventricular reverse modeling. So the higher the dose of ERNI which you use, the higher are the chances of reverse remodeling which can occur with that. So with that in mind, this was the proof heart failure trial, which showed what is the remodeling of the myocardium, whether it is central to progression of heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, and whether it is associated with risk reduction of the cardiovascular events. We know in the paradigm of heart failure, reduction in the NT-proBNP with the guideline determined medical therapy for reduced ejection fraction, heart failure with reduced ejection fraction is associated with reverse cardiac remodeling. So this was the thing which was taken into consideration for the PROOVIT heart failure. And this was a phase 4 52-week trial wherein they were put on ERNI, and they determined what was the fall in the NT-proBNP as well as the cardiac remodeling to see what are the benefits of this particular drug. And the goals of this particular study was to see the correlation between the change in the NT-proBNP and remodeling at 12 months, which looked at the left ventricular ejection fraction, the left ventricular end-diastolic volume index, the left ventricular systolic volume index, the left atrial volume index, and the ratio of the mitral diastolic filling velocity and early diastolic mitral annular velocity. That is the diastolic function of the left ventricle. And what did they find? They found that the NT-proBNP concentration reduced significantly during the first 2 weeks of therapy of ERNI. This is out of proportion to what you find with enalapril therapy. There is significant reduction in the NT-proBNP. And does it translate on to the benefits or not? We will see that. What happens to the reverse cardiac remodeling? They found that the LV ejection fraction in about 25% of the patients, the LV ejection fraction increased by almost about 13% at the end of 12 months. And this benefit was seen even at the end of 6 months, wherein the ejection fraction rose by about 5 to 7%. What happened to the LV end diastolic volume index and the left ventricular end systolic volume index? Both of them tend to go down with ERNI therapy, and the effect is translated at the end of 6 months also, but the benefit is much more at the end of 12 months. What happens to the LV left atrial volume index? That also significantly reduces. That means it tells you that the compliance of the ventricle has also improved, and that is shown in the E:8 ratio, which shows that there is significant reduction of this particular ratio at the end of 12 months, showing that the compliance of the left ventricle has improved significantly with ERNI therapy. So death and heart failure by 12 months showed that patients with largest reduction in the NT-proBNP and the LV end systolic volume index by 6 months had the lowest rates of subsequent death or heart failure hospitalization by 12 months. So what was the conclusion of PROOV heart failure trial? In this study of patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction treated with the ERNI combination, reduction in NT-proBNP was significantly associated with reverse cardiac remodeling. The degree of reverse cardiac remodeling demonstrated may help to explain how ERNI reduces morbidity and mortality in patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction. This was another study, which was the Evaluate Heart Failure study, where the objective was designed to determine whether treatment of heart failure with reduced ejection fraction with ERNI improves central aortic stiffness and cardiac remodeling compared to enalapril. However, it showed that among patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, ERNI did not reduce the aortic wall stiffness as compared to enalapril. However, significant reductions were seen in patients who were on ERNI in the left ventricle and left atrial volumes, as well as the diastolic function of the left ventricle, suggesting a favorable impact on ventricular remodeling and filling pressures. I'll just to show you about two practical scenarios. One case is wherein you have a male, 58 years of old, salaried worker, New York Heart Association class 2. He has an ejection fraction of about 35%. He has a blood pressure about 130 by 84. His NT-proBNP levels are marginally high, about 340. His creatinine is 1.2 milligram per deciliter. In comorbidities, he has diabetes, and he's taking optimal dose of ERNI, beta blockers, MRA, and diuretics. Now, can replacing an ACE inhibitor with ERNI is likely to help reduce the symptoms and help him achieve better quality of life or not? Why should ERNI be initiated in this patient? It shows that ERNI by itself has a significant impact on the quality of life besides improving the other parameters as far as mortality and the rehospitalization is concerned. And this is particularly so in patients with diabetes, which favors that if you have a patient on ERNI in a diabetic who has got low ejection fraction, the quality of life is going to be much better. Fewer patients treated with ERNI combination considered themselves worse across the glycemic categories. And what is the impact of mortality in patients with diabetes? It's also showed that there is a significant favorable impact of patients of diabetes with reduced ejection fraction when they were on ERNI. So in this patient, replacing an ACE inhibitor with sacubitril valsartan can reduce his symptoms, prevent clinical progression, improve his quality of life, lower his blood pressure, provide mortality benefit, and his morbidity status, whether it is diabetes. It is in line with the guideline recommendations, and patient should be monitored. Only thing is that patient should be monitored for serum creatinine levels and serum potassium, especially if they are also along with on MRAs. The second case study is the one which is usually where we are a little concerned about, and that is if you have a patient who is about 62 years old, who comes in the New York Heart classification grade 2, has an ejection fraction of about 32%, has a blood pressure of about 100/70, NT-proBNP which is significantly high, that is 1200, creatinine is fairly okay, and is taking optimal dose of ACE, beta blockers, MRA and diuretic. Can replacing ACE inhibitors with ERNI is going to be beneficial despite her low blood pressure. NT-proBNP effects, as I already told, that it significantly reduces the NT-proBNP on initiation of ERNI, and that starts much early, and by the end of 2 weeks you get significant reduction in the NT-proBNP levels. And when the NT-proBNP levels are reduced, you understand that there is going to be almost 60% lower risk of primary endpoint, that is cardiovascular mortality as well as rehospitalization, when you bring down the NT-proBNP as early as possible. As far as recommended management of hypotension in patients on ERNI, in case of symptomatic hypotension, see if the patient has been volume depleted, particularly if you see that the patient is in large doses of diuretic therapy, unnecessary, too much of dietary salt restriction, or has concomitant diarrhea and vomiting. If that is so, then dose adjustment of diuretic is required. If the patient is also on concomitant antihypertensive drug, you need to bring down the dosage. Treatment of other cause of hypertension may be hypovolemic, you have to give them fluids. So dose reduction or temporary discontinuation of sacubitril or ERNI is recommended in such patients, but permanent discontinuation of ERNI is usually not required. Sodium and or volume depletion should be corrected before starting treatment with ERNI. And this is the chart which is taken from Paradigm Heart Failure sub-analysis, which showed that the benefits of ERNI, even in patients with persistently low systolic blood pressure, was quite superior as compared to enalapril, and this translated into reduction in mortality as well as morbidity. So these benefits are translated to reduction of cardiovascular death and rehospitalization. So in this patient, replacing ACE inhibitor with sacubitril is going to reduce the NT-proBNP and hence reduce the risk of primary events, and despite low systolic blood pressure, ERNI will reduce the mortality and morbidity and prevent clinical worsening. Thank you so much.